this really hasn't changed much since we presented it maybe 6 months ago. With the top 10 other than satisfied requirements, and I have another slide that kind of puts the names to this, you see the numbers here. Does anyone know what 313.11 is? Yep, FIPS, right? So that is the number one that we see. And we understand the FIPS requirements can be a challenge, particularly because, you know, if you patch a system and... So you patch a system, maybe it changed the module, and now maybe it's not FIPS compliant because it's not operating in the way that it was tested because you changed out that module, but you closed a zero-day vulnerability. So when we perform that assessment, we're not going to ding a company for that. They're doing the right things. They're patching their systems. And so you can't take a hardline approach. Where we would ding someone is if they've never implemented something that was FIPS compliant, right? And we understand that, you know, those products sometimes can be expensive, right? But, you know, it's the requirement as it stands now. And that may change slightly in the next revision of the 800-171. And I do encourage everyone to use the public comment period to provide their input when NIST makes that available. Because for me, I think that is the most challenging, right, aspect for particularly a small company. You might be a 5-10 person shop. You just want to get, you know, Wi-Fi, your networking, and you don't want to go out and buy necessarily these really expensive products. Or maybe you don't even know when you're buying it to look for that FIPS certificate. So you just go out and buy something that accomplishes the mission for what you're doing to get your folks online. And you kind of overlook that requirement. And now you have this assessment. They come in and say, all the stuff that you bought, like, really needed to have this certificate to be this product that has gone through the testing. And, you know, that's hard to tell a small company, because to be compliant, they would have to trash maybe this equipment that they just bought in the last year and go out and buy something else. And a lot of companies don't have that capital, right? So, you know, really their best approach, right? Take the partial credit, put it on a POAM, and when you do the tech refresh, kind of go through that. And that's why right now, when we're still in the 7012 DFARS, it's important for folks to understand things like this so that when we get to CMMC and you're looking at things as a binary point, right? Pass, fail, maybe a temporary POAM, maybe not. You know, just depends on how the rulemaking goes. You may only have a short runway to get where you need to be. And so that's why it's very important for folks to understand now what some of these implementations are.